ओके ओके ठीक है सर।
You had mentioned in our last interview in June that India will be one
हाँ
of the few countries that will bounce back with great vigor, and now India is the fastest growing large economy with 9% growth. What do you have to say now?
India going to last of years. I think the growth that we're talking today, and if you look at all the agencies who are very clear that India will come out from the pandemic pretty strong. Now we already predicted that we will be having a specifically with what is happening in China and Western European countries. So India will become one of the favored destination for FDI and manufacturing.
So what is your opinion with Omicron virus will have on the economy?
I think Omicron is supposed to be a mild virus compared to the previous one, but the infectious percentage is very high. So the difference is that it will not affect the hospital or the healthcare sector so much. And the fatality percentage of people getting affected by or having a serious issue with Omicron will be very low. But personally, my opinion, I mean, and reading and hearing the experts, I think that with the mutations happening, changing every 15 days, and one new mutation being found world over, I think now the people have got used to that. The government also, some of the governments are going to live with the virus. So I think it is the vaccine will play a very big role, and of course, the appropriate COVID behavior.
Can India handle the challenge? And where do you see the challenges, opportunities in the next 12 months?
I think India has handled very well. Nobody expected 150 crore vaccination happening. And we have already vaccinated 150 crores plus. And the second dose around 50% plus. And we have a booster dose starting for the healthcare professionals and the senior people, as of today. So, and before March end, I think we should be covering double dose by at least by 90% of the population. And the younger generation probably will be over by June. So I think we are in a very good space, and the central and the state government has played a very, very important role in ensuring that the vaccination takes place. And I would not say the lockdowns are the necessity for controlling the COVID, but I think a managed lockdown is acceptable.
What are the sectors that will be affected and who will benefit?
The sector that will be affected and which is already affecting is the hospital and industry. If you see the cancellation of events in hotels, physical really events inside. In Bombay, I think there's no event relating being held, the events that probably should take place. So they will be facing a huge thing. The hotel reservations have been cancelled. The wedding scenario, the small industry will be facing the challenges. And I think these challenges are going to be for next maybe 4 or 6 months, not after that. I think the Omicron will dilute or will come down, I think, mid of March to end of March. So it's a matter of another 2-3 months or maybe 4 months, I would say, that these industries will bounce back.
What do you have to say about the startups world increasing numbers, becoming unicorn and also getting listed?
So I'm very excited about the startup world. I think what the Indians did in US in the Silicon Valley is probably being replicated in India last 1.5 years. Of course, we had startup, we had unicorn a couple of years back, but now the space of unicorn in India is growing at every 10 days we have a unicorn coming. I think in the next 6 months, we'll probably have once in a week, one unicorn happening. And today the big guys are ready to put in, hundreds of millions of dollars in a particular startup in India. And India is a space where they are quite excited. They believe the engineering colleges, the medical, the management student that is coming out will probably add up to the startup world. Prime reason is they believe that they can achieve their dreams in India rather than have to, they have to go to the US or UK or somewhere else. So I think that is the change. That's the mentality change. Also, the startup world feels that whatever we develop today in India can be used world over. And getting listed in US for an Indian startup based in India, I think that's happening. So I think it's a great space to be in.
What do you have to say about COVID management of the government?
I think everybody accepts that the COVID management, also the experts that we accept that had been pretty good. When we started vaccination, nobody believed that we can touch, you know, the number of doses that we have done today, and 150 and touching 200 in maybe next 2 or 3 months is a great achievement. And we have to also give the coordination between the central and state government. I think if you go to see that, that'd be pretty awesome. I mean, you look at the 20 plus states, today a lot of people are compared, you know, telling that we vaccinated 90% or 100% of our adult population. So this has been great, great working between central government and state government and the agencies. I think hats off to them what they have done.
What are your views on the stock market in general?
I like to put it that way. I think when we are talking of the India as an economy growing at 9% plus, India as a market which is getting FDI is probably the biggest FDI destination in the world today, and the startup making a noise, startup getting listed. I don't see a reason why the stock market should not grow, and it will be one of the benchmarks world over that India's stock market is outperformed for a lot of people's expectation.
Anything else you would like to add to today's scenario?
No, I'm very happy with the you know, everybody expected the virus to create hell for India, but I think it's just the reverse. Today, I foresee a lot of SME and MSME companies. Of course, there are challenges in cash flow. There are challenges sometimes creating a new market. But that is bound to happen because of the way the environment is. I mean, we have the online industry growing much faster than the manufacturing base. But I think India is a great space, I mean, to be in. And I'm pretty sure the SME and MSME will be making a noise in a couple of years.
Thank you, sir. Nice talking with you.
Pleasure talking to you always. Thank you. Thank you very much.